Hello friends, welcome to our channel. Today I am going to discuss with you about some secrets behind Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose death. Previously I have discussed with you about the life of Netaji in short. According to government report, Subhash Chandra Bose was killed in an air crash over Taipei, Taiwan on August 18, 1945. But people of India did not believe this. They thought that Netaji was still alive and one day he would surely come back to India. In the year 1915, some files were released by the West Bengal government on the death of Subhash Chandra Bose. Scraps of information have already escaped. Reports of documents revealing that British and American intelligence agencies believed him to be alive in 1949, inciting communist uprisings in Southeast Asia. Letters from a Swiss journalist, Lily Abeg, to Bose's brother, written in 1949, reporting that he had been sighted in the city then known as Peking, and that the Japanese knew he was alive in 1946. These letters had been intercepted at the Elgin Road post office. The files held by the Kolkata police and the West Bengal police for decades are said to confirm what Intelligence Bureau files declassified in April have already revealed. The government snooped on Bose's family for 20 years after his death. Letters flowing in and out of the Bose family home and Netaji Bhavan in Kolkata were regularly intercepted at the Elgin Road post office. Now it's all eyes on Delhi, which still refuses to declassify most of the files in the possession of the central government. The family want a new committee to investigate why they were spied on for decades and to establish whether documents containing information on the leader's death were destroyed. But governments have been forming committees since the time Bose reportedly died in that plane crash in Taipei in 1945. Instead of answering questions for the public, these committee reports have only set off new ripples of mystery. The British government in India naturally took a lively interest in Bose's whereabouts and activities. Prime Minister Winston Churchill is even said to have prepared a plot to assassinate him back in 1941. Bose was the master of disguise, escaping under the nose of British authorities in Kolkata. So when the first reports of his death started emerging, the British were having none of it. Shomor Guho, a close associate of Bose and later a member of parliament, describes the British probe in his book Netaji, Dead or Alive. It was in 1978. Three separate intelligence teams were dispatched to find out where he really was. These teams spread out to Saigon, Bangkok, Tokyo and Taipei, raided war offices, arrested Japanese officials and officers of Bose Indian National Army. Officers of both nationalities were interrogated in Tokyo and at the Red Fort. Colonel Figes submitted his report in July 1946 and in October, a military intelligence report was submitted. Kanailal Basu, author of Netaji, rediscovered records the various discrepancies between the two reports. They produced separate medical certificates signed by two different doctors, giving different accounts of the patient's condition, time of death, and the process of identification. The Figes report stated that Bose had indeed perished in a hospital in Taipei. But unlike every other report, it was sucked into the mysteries around Bose's death. Kanailal Basu asked why it took so long for the report to be submitted. Was a conspiracy being hatched? The figures report was part of work done under Indian political intelligence, a partly secret branch of the colonial government. In 1997, the British released most of the IPI files, but not the figures report. It was anonymously made public later. Why did the British government find it necessary to keep the document classified after all those years? Then Shahnawaz Commission of 1956. After independence, the Indian government seemed unusually reticent about Bose's death, even reluctant to set up a committee of inquiry. But when some eminent citizens decided to start an unofficial probe, headed by Radha Vinod Pal, Nehru suddenly announced the formation of an official committee, headed by Shah Nawaz Khan, Bose's elder brother. Suresh Bose was also part of this committee. Members of the committee listened to the testimonies of witnesses at military hospital and survivors of the plane crash. The Indian government apparently produced some of its secret documents to the committee, including sections of the figures report, Mountbatten's diaries, and interrogations of Habibur Rahman, Bose's aide and a traveller on that plane, conducted by British counterintelligence in the 1940s. The Shahnawaz report confirmed the official version. Bose died in Taipei, but Suresh Bose filed a dissenting report, alleging that Khan had been influenced by Nehru to stick to the official line. Khan had also said he, Suresh Bose, could become West Bengal governor if only he would agree to the findings. In the 1970, Khan refuted these allegations before the Khosla Commission set up in 1970. The Indian government later set up a one-man inquiry commission consisting of Justice G.D. Khosla, a retired judge of the Punjab High Court. He only submitted his report in 1974. Once again, Khosla concurred with the earlier reports. According to Bose biographer Leonard B. Gordon, he also questioned the motives of those who held up alternative theories. Justice Khosla suggests the motives of many of the story purveyors are less than altruistic. Some, he says, have clearly been driven by political goals, or simply wanted to call attention to themselves. Khosla reportedly showed remarkable patience in listening to a range of stories, some of which verged on the fantastic. But he seems to have been curiously lacking in curiosity about other aspects of the investigation. Once again, the government had made secret documents available for the probe, but tacked to one of the dossiers was a note listing 30 secret files that were either missing or destroyed. Guho says these were part of Nehru's own collection of confidential papers. The missing files had all been handled by Muhammad Yunus, who was later appointed Indira Gandhi's special envoy. They had contained British and American reports produced in Tokyo and outposts in Southeast Asia. One of the destroyed files was entitled Investigation into the Circumstances Leading to the Death of Subhash Chandra Bose. A large part of the Habibur Rahman interrogations were reportedly not submitted either. Why did Khosla never pursue the case of the missing files? They would surely have yielded a more complete picture. Then Mukherjee Commission. 4 decades after that, the government seems to have lost interest in Bose. Until that is, the Justice Mukherjee Commission was formed in 1999. The commission produced a report that ran into 3 volumes and thousands of pages and was made public in 2006. The commission raised the matter of the missing documents and interviewed 131 witnesses. Its probe took its members to archives in London, to Russia, where it went through more papers and interviewed witnesses, and to Taiwan. It also visited the Renkoji Temple in Japan, where Bose ashes are apparently kept, and recommended a DNA test of the remains. This was no longer possible, it was told. The Mukherjee Commission report concluded that Bose did not die in the plane crash of 1945. His death and cremation were engineered with the cooperation of the Japanese military authorities and of Habibur Rahman himself. The government rejected the report. Then Cabinet Secretaries Committee 2015. Too much time has perhaps gone by to hold a direct investigation into Bose's death. The documents which contain the fact of his death have become a mystery in their own right, and the focus has shifted to the question of declassification. In April 2015, after it became evident that the government had snooped on the Bose for decades, the center set up a committee to explore whether the files could be declassified and to review the ARCIAC official secret acts, which is impenetrable by the right to information in many cases. It would be headed by the cabinet secretary Ajit Seth and include officials from intelligence agencies. What this committee found is not known, but the center has found its reason not to declassify the documents and is sticking to it. Revealing them will affect national security. The plot thickens. So friends, all this concludes that some top Indian leaders planned a conspiracy with British government to kill Netaji. But Netaji was successful in escaping from them. But ultimately what happened to Netaji, nobody knows. Netaji's death remained a mystery forever. So friend, if you like my channel, please give a like and subscribe to my channel. And thank you all for very much for being with me all this time.